Life of a product designer is designing. No, it's about meetings. I have 5 meetings per day at least. So think twice if you want to be a product designer. Portrait. So thank you. So today I am working from very weird places around the cottage, and it's so nice to sit outside after this long winter and just, you know, be able to enjoy the sun and the pure air and listen to the birds and also the neighbor making renovation. And this is something that I think I started to really appreciate in Sweden, not only because winters are quite tough and dark, but I think it's because the nature here is so beautiful and it's the air is so pure and so nice that you want to stay outside. So I feel very grateful for this trip and for this weather, because I know that now in Poland it's very rainy and in Sweden it's really nice, so I feel very happy about that. So for all those friends of mine who told me not to move here because it's always shitty weather, huh? Who is right now? Who has better weather? Yeah, so I'm gonna continue working. It's a busy day today. So I just finished my work day, and it was full of meetings and full of work, and I managed to focus, and I don't know, I feel like I have some midlife crisis or something. No, but seriously, like, I feel like since I always have this thing, I don't know if you have it too, but when I'm on vacation, especially in the place like that, I feel like I don't know what I'm doing with my life, why I'm like so much chasing my, like, not chasing, but choosing my career over my free time and like, you know, focusing so much on earning money. And I mean, I still live in Sweden, and I think that in general my life is much slower than it used to be. I mean, not I think, I know that, but still, like, when I'm here and I experience this, like, peacefulness, and I really had a good time here, and I managed to work and also to spend a lot of quality time, and I, you know, wasn't watching Netflix during evenings. I was spending, like, good time here. But, you know, like, I feel like when I'm in the city, all days look the same. I work, I wake up in the morning, I, you know, eat breakfast, work 8 hours, I don't see the sun because I'm inside most of the time, and then when I'm done by the end of the day, it's like, you know, maybe I would take a walk. If I take a walk, I work out and eat dinner, and that's it, and watch Netflix till I am so tired that I sleep. There is this, like, rat race that's it's always happens in, like, bigger cities, that we all participate more or less, and yeah, I kind of catch myself in it, and I feel like I want to stop, but I don't know how. Like, I don't want to miss out on my career, I don't want to get worse at design because I decide to spend more free time or travel more. I don't want to earn less, but I want to work less. And, you know, all of this capitalistic thinking. So I don't know if it's some crisis that I have, or I will just come back to Stockholm and I will be back to normal, and I will just go back to work and forget about all of this. There is part of me that starts to notice that maybe living in the city, it's not what I want. or I don't know, maybe it's not necessarily about the city, but the quality of my time, that I want to be more happy, more with myself, focus on things that I really like and I really enjoy, not only, you know, work, sleep and repeat, and sometimes take day off here or there and still feel guilty about that. So, well, I don't know, it got a bit, I don't know, personal here, but maybe you have solution for that, maybe you figured this out already, so maybe you can let me know. But I think that I am privileged enough to work towards this goal of working less and maybe earning less money because of that, but also accepting that and you know, just having more fun in life. Maybe my first step could be working Monday to Thursday instead of Monday to Friday, at least to have a longer weekend and spend this time on going out or traveling or just, you know, doing things that I like. So that is my reflection.
We are going back home tomorrow. Yeah, I mean, places like that, that makes you think. I think it's because you finally have time for that and finally have space to think and to question things. Wow, Raymond, you are such a deep person. Amazing. Yeah. That's it. What do you think? So weird to talk to the camera like that. I kinda get used to that. Those vlogs makes me... I don't know. I feel like I don't see the camera anymore. I kinda see the people who are watching this. And it's, by the way, very weird that someone is watching this. I saw my friend posting that she was watching it with her family. And like, it was so weird. Like, wow, people are actually watching me. Maybe I should be more careful what I'm saying and showing. But anyway, planning to have a good last day here. Barbecue again. And enjoy the sun. And no TVs on. No Netflix. Yep. By the way, Sam went to sauna now. That's why I record this stuff, because it is very awkward to... I mean, I'm not able to talk to the camera when she's around. I think it's annoying when someone talks to the camera next to you. And like, it must feel so weird. So, I don't think I will learn how to do it anytime soon. Hello. Subscribe to Magda. My name is Johan. Also, I think I'm getting old and sentimental or something, but I was never a person who would take a photo of sunset or nature. I never found it interesting and never could understand. I think I still can't understand, but the thing is, like, with video everything moves nicely, there is light and everything is so pretty. So I take a lot of videos of that, so you will see this in this vlog. So I'm sorry, I'm just getting old. So I'm soon gonna be like your aunt on Facebook that shares photos of their morning coffee and says that you should have a good coffee time or something. I'm sorry, you know. You subscribe, or if you didn't, you should, because you should subscribe to your aunt. Swedish cottage. Swedish barn. Swedish cute house. Another cute house. Come here. No? She's very confused. I think Swedes don't talk to cows. Look. Yes. Oh my god. It's You're fat. That's a status. Hey. This is the best day of my life. Oh my fucking They are running. Oh my god. What? What have I done? So cute. Do you think I can pet them or they're gonna eat me? You know that the cows, they when you have a bell or music, they come to you. They're very sensitive. Come to Auntie Magda.
They all came to you.
But I want to hug them.
Stop it, maybe you are offending them.
Oh, the curious one come, the next one. Hey! Do you want to say hi? Can I pet you? Will you let me? Let me? Look, I'm a human. I'm sorry. Wow, you have a big nose like me. Mm-hmm. Come on. Come, honey. Come. Huh? I'm not...
Breath is like...
We should take them for barbecue, they would start the fire easily. Bye! Auntie Magda loves you. The best day of my life. And the whole vlog is gonna be about it. I'm not gonna edit anything. It's gonna be 3 hours with cows. They are following us! I have friends! Oh my god, I'm crying. They are just making sure that we leave. Hey.
Give me.
Yes, my small nose. And you're so cute too. Oh, boy.
Yeah, so I was planning to have this grumpy video and then I saw cows and I don't think this day could get any better, maybe if we saw mooses or something. But I guess it proves my point that being in this countryside is much cooler than being in Stockholm, at least for me. That's my life goals, hanging out with cows. Yeah. That's it. Wasn't it me who said that nothing good's